and welcoming John Paul Stevens High School. I'm Cadet Captain Jasmine Morris. Please rise and remain standing for the post of the colors, followed by the national anthem. The national anthem will be performed by the John Paul Stevens Jazz Lab Band. The colors will be posted by the Texas 251st Air Force JROTC Color Guard. Commanding the team and carrying the American flag is Cadet Captain Brianna Pena. Carrying the Texas flag is Cadet Second Lieutenant Kira Aponte. The right guard is Cadet Second Lieutenant Michelle Rivera. The left guard is Cadet First Lieutenant Jimena Gonzalez. You may be seated.
My name is Rob Pascal, and today we're going to learn about Veterans Day. Veterans Day is always celebrated on November 11th, and I'll tell you why in just a bit. First, I need to tell you what a veteran is. A veteran is someone who has served in the military, also known as the armed forces. And Veterans Day, it's a day where we honor those who have served in the military. Did you know that the military has five parts, also known as branches? The Army, the Marine Corps, the Navy, the Air Force, and the Coast Guard. Together, they all serve to defend our freedom. Kind of a big deal. Respect. So if you meet a veteran, ask them what branch they serve in, and then tell them they're awesome. The reason we celebrate Veterans Day on November 11th is that is the day that World War I ended in 1918 at 11 o'clock on the 11th day in the 11th month. An armistice was signed to end the war. An armistice is an agreement between two opposing sides that ends a war. Everyone was so glad that the war was over that the next year, 1919, 100 years ago today, the U.S. declared November 11th as Armistice Day to celebrate the ending of the war. It's called Armistice Day every year until 1954, when President Dwight D. Eisenhower changed it from Armistice Day day to honor all service members who have served our country to defend our freedom. Marine Corps. And that's your lesson on this day in Canadian history. Broadcast count out.
Good evening, and welcome to the Red Feather Jazz Salute to the Armed Forces. We are excited to treat our veterans to an exciting night of music and celebration. You might be wondering why we are performing so many unique jazz charts for a veteran celebration, but all these tunes are rooted in United States military history. The music you are about to hear was all recorded in the 1940s during World War II on V-Disc, short for Victory Disc. These records raised millions of dollars to fund the war efforts. Did you know that Captain Glenn Miller and the Air Force Jazz Band had 69 top 10 hits during the war? That is more top 10 hits than anyone in history, even more than Elvis Presley and the Beatles. We hope you enjoy this music as a token of our appreciation for the service you have provided to this country. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a round of applause for the Stevens High School Red Feather Jazz Lab Band.
I'm sure that hearing the excitement and joy this music had a healing effect for those men and women who gave so much, very similar to the sacrifices our veterans here have made. Glenn Miller always opened up his concerts with this next tune you're going to hear. Captain Miller was very specific. He wanted these concerts opened with a piece that would be calming and soothing. I hope this has the same effect on you all, even 80 years later. Please welcome to the stage our guest artist for this piece, Ms. Malia Martin.
Thank you. I think she deserves one more round of applause. That was fantastic. And how about the Red Feather Jazz Lab Band? Thank you all so much. I promise this is the one time during the concert I'll talk too much, but I just wanted to say that putting on a production like this that honors our veterans and the military family members around us is so special and dear to my heart. I'm always routinely inspired since I was a little kid, just thinking about that someone could look at the protection that our country needs and to decide to make that sacrifice to protect it themselves. I think that's always so honorable, and I think we really should give the veterans in the audience right now a round of applause for that. As Addison mentioned earlier, it's kind of strange, a Veterans Day production surrounded by all of this jazz music, but in all of these tunes you're hearing, there is really this untold story during these really, really troubling times in the world that people decided to use music and this joy and love and the energy that comes from this music to almost like a distraction or a healing factor during these, you know, very, very hard times. And each one of these tunes is so rooted in military history. As Addison talked about, Glenn Miller wrote the majority of the things that we're playing today. If not him, it was someone else who was enlisted in the military at the same time serving with these bands. And these bands toured all over the country and all over Europe, just healing people with the sound of music and giving people a little piece of home from wherever they are. So we are fortunate enough, and we really hope that 80 years later, we're kind of providing you the same type of reaction, that even though sometimes things can be hard in the world right now, you get to come to this and hear some really, really smart and awesome students provide some really good music for you guys. So anyway, we're very, very excited to do that. And this will be the last one that the lab band's gonna play. This is our non-varsity jazz ensemble. So these are usually some of our younger students, which is very impressive with the music that they're playing. Some of those charts you just heard are actually listed for professional musicians. So these 14, 15, 16 year olds are playing professional level charts, which is pretty amazing. So this next chart is everybody's favorite. If you haven't heard it, it's gonna become your favorite. Please welcome the Red Feather Lab Band and Sing, Sing, Sing. We'll be right back. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the Armed Forces Medley performed by the Red Feather Big Band.
Thank you.
the United States Marine Corps. In order to protect it. Thank you, and a very special thank you to our veterans.
Thank you.
much for sticking through us for this concert. It's just such an honor to get to put on a production like this. We have one more world famous selection for you that we hope you enjoy, and we have a special surprise for it as well. So, last but not least, let's give one more round of applause for the veterans in the audience. This is all about them. Thank y'all very much, and without further ado, this is the Red Feather Big Band and the Sky Dancers performing Glenn Miller's Captain Glenn Miller of the Air Force in the Moon.
This is Captain Glenn Miller speaking for the Army Air Force's Training Command, Archbishop. We hope that you soldiers of the Allied Forces enjoy these B-discs that we're making just for you.